So the next hypothalamic hormone that we are talking about today is the corticotropin releasing hormone, also called the CRH. And the CRH is a peptide of 41 amino acids that is derived from a 196 amino acid pre-pro hormone. So the major function of the corticotropin releasing hormone is that it activates the anterior pituitary to release the adrenocorticotropic hormone. And the adrenocorticotropic hormone acts on the adrenal cortex to release cortisol. Right? So this is the set of reactions that take place. And the corticotropin releasing hormone, or the CRH, is secreted by the paraventricular nucleus of the hypothalamus in response to stress conditions inside the body. So increased CRH production has been also observed to be associated with Alzheimer's disease as well as in major depression. So as the name indicates, it acts on cells in the anterior lobe of pituitary to release adrenocorticotropic hormone. So this is the pre-pro hormone that is initially seen. And from that, two major products can be produced. One is the pro-opiomelanocortin or the adrenocorticotropic hormone, and the beta-lipotropin hormone. So from the POMC, you can cleave it into two parts. One is the pro-gamma MSH, and MSH is melanocyte-stimulating hormone, and the ACTH, that is adrenocorticotropic hormone. So the ACTH gets degraded into, it can be converted into CLIP protein and the alpha MSH protein, whereas the pro-gamma MSH forms the gamma MSH protein, peptide. And the beta-lipotropin peptide can be degraded to form gamma-lipotropin and beta-endorphin. And gamma-lipotropin gives rise to beta-MSH. Beta-endorphin gives rise to gamma-endorphin and alpha-endorphin. So from a single precursor protein, you get several hormones. Example is ACTH, melanocyte stimulating hormone, gamma, alpha, and beta, adrenocorticotropic hormone, beta lipotropin, gamma lipotropin, beta endorphin, alpha, and gamma endorphin. So you have different products from the same precursor. So the biological functions of CRH is that CRH can suppress appetite, increase subjective feelings of anxiety. These are the feelings that you feel when you are in stress. You do not feel hungry and under stress. You feel anxiety inside yourself, and perform other functions like boosting attention. And the activation of the CRH1 receptor produces euphoric feelings that accompany alcohol consumption. So abnormally high levels of CRH has been found in the CSF, or the cerebrospinal fluid, of people who have committed suicide. So high levels of CRH is usually seen under conditions of stress. So the action of CRH on the cells of the adrenal cortex: the CRH binds to membrane receptors. This is the membrane receptor. So CRH binds to the membrane receptor, which is coupled to a G protein coupled stimulatory G protein. And it's called the stimulatory G protein is called GS, which activates the adrenal cyclase, which in effect produces cyclic AMP from ATP. The cyclic AMP activates protein kinase A, and the protein kinase A phosphorylates several proteins, which will increase the transcription of the CRH hormone from the nucleus. And the mRNA that you get, that is the pro-opiomelanocortin mRNA that you get, goes into the rough endoplasmic reticulum, where the pre-pro hormone is cut to form the pro hormone. And from the rough endoplasmic reticulum, it goes to the Golgi apparatus, where the pro hormone is cut to form the hormone, active hormone. So you get the pro-opiomelanocortin hormone, which is then packaged into secretory granules, inside of which it is split into several hormones like ACTH and beta-lipotropin. Right? So, what is the mechanism of CRH regulation in human pregnant women, particularly in the myometrium, before and during labor? So, before the onset of labor, CRHR1, that is the corticotropin releasing hormone receptor 1, is the CRH binds to CRHR1 in non-labor conditions and activates adenine cyclase, produces cyclic AMP, produces protein kinase A, or activates protein kinase A, which in turn inhibits the inositol triphosphate and the phospholipase C mediated pathway of the same protein, right? So the inositol triphosphate is inhibited, as a result of which calcium in intracellular calcium concentration is not allowed to increase by inhibiting its release from the sarcoplasmic reticulum, and the muscles remain in a relaxed condition, not in a contracted condition, remains in a relaxed condition. So during labor, the CRHR1 couples to G alpha Q and G alpha I proteins. As a result, because it's an inhibitory G protein, the adenyl cyclase becomes inhibited. Protein kinase A activation also becomes inhibited. Whereas the phospholipase C activation happens and the inositol triphosphate is produced in higher concentrations. So the inositol triphosphate will increase the release of calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum so that the intracellular calcium will increase, and the the myometrial cells go into the contraction state, not in the relaxation state, it goes into the contraction state. So this is a condition, these are the conditions when a person is administrated with CRH, that is, it induces CRH production, acts on immune cells, modulates cytokine production, and regulates cell proliferation. So next is the regulation of the CRH. So the CRH is positively regulated by cytokines, catecholamines, oxytocin receptors, glucocorticoids, and prostaglandins. So these are prostaglandins, PGE, PGF, PGH, and PGD. So all these are prostaglandins. And CRH is negatively inhibited by progesterone and nitric oxide. Okay. So the CRH in effect produces a positive effect on the fetal pituitary and the fetal adrenal gland. Okay, this is the process. The hypothalamus releases CRH, or corticotropin releasing hormone, which stimulates the anterior pituitary to release ACTH. And the ACTH secreted by the anterior pituitary activates the adrenal cortex to release cortisol. The cortisol that is produced produces a negative inhibition, feedback inhibition, of both the anterior pituitary and the hypothalamus. Thank you.